So a very good evening once again, all of you. I'm following 13th edition, Grossman 13th edition for today's discussion. Right? So initially we'll have some summary of the topic which we're going to discuss today, and then we'll jump into textbook discussion. Right? So we'll break this entire session into two. We'll take 15 to 20 minutes summarizing all these concepts in brief, and then we'll go into the details of literature and try and get some key points like what's given in your Grossman latest edition. I'll be following 13th edition, right? Yeah. Hi, a very good evening once again. So today we'll be starting with this concept of principal techniques for root canal instrumentation. As I've been discussing previously, so we have one recorded video also on principal motions of root canal instrumentation. You can check out the classes later. You'll be getting that video by tomorrow. So we have discussed about circumferential filing motion, ringing motion, everything pertaining to different principal motions which we use while using different hand instruments in endodontics. So the focus of today's presentation is, as we have discussed previously in our schedule, so we'll be dealing with various principal techniques for root canal instrumentation, which we follow for the sake of cleaning and shaping the canals, right? So we have a lot many techniques, and the latest edition gives you the summary of all the information, and the presentation is quite good. You have even tables with scientists, and also you have all the techniques summarized in a brief manner in a wonderful flowcharts, right? So it enables you to understand the concept in a much more simplified manner. So first 15-20 minutes, I'll just take trying to summarize all the important points in this entire topic, and then we'll go into textbook discussion. So as you can see, assume that this is an apical third, middle third, and caudal third of a root canal. Now we have different techniques for root canal instrumentation. So we have this step back technique, crown down technique, and hybrid technique. So the name itself gives you a lot of information. Like a step back technique means we start from the apical third and then step back or move coronally 1 mm, or it depends upon the technique which you are following. Because again, in step back, we have conventional and passive step back, which we'll discuss later. So step back is something where we start from the apical third and then move to the middle third and coronal third. So that's the concept here. But crown down, as the name itself indicates, we start from the coronal third and then move towards the apical third. So we start from the coronal third, middle third, and apical third. Now, if you observe this hybrid technique, so it optimizes the advantages of both step back and crown down. So we use a combination, like first we'll start with coronal third, followed by apical third, followed by middle third. So this is the concept behind these three techniques. And the scientist names, if you ask me, yes, it's better if you can memorize, right? So step back technique, the conventional step back technique was given by Wien and Schilder. Whereas we have the step back passive technique, which was given by Torabi Najat. So you remember Torabi Najat, the person who has introduced or discovered this MTA, Loma Linda University, way back in 1990s. So step back conventional technique was given by Wien. So step back passive technique given by Torabi Najat. And then you have this crown down technique. So crown down, again, you have a lot many modifications, like a conventional pressureless balanced force and double flip. So the conventional technique, pressureless technique given by Marshall and Patrick. There is a conventional technique given by Goerich, G-O-E-R-H. Balanced force technique, you have these Ronne files, flexor files, right? So Ronne technique, given by Ronne and Savala. And double flare technique, FLAW. So names of scientists pertain to these techniques. It's better if you can memorize that. So first we'll start with a step back technique in brief. So as you're all familiar with, that's what you might have done in your final year or in your internship periods, right? So first we'll establish working length, we'll establish patency, we'll establish working length, and then we'll start from the working length part. For example, assume that the working length is 25 mm. So we make sure that we enlarge the apical third first in case of step back technique. So the initial binding file, assume it is 15K. And then we try to enlarge it 3 times or 4 times greater till 30 or 35K. It in fact depends on the tool. Anterior, the size where it is, posterior, the size where it is. Assume that you have done your apical cleaning till your 35K file, till the working length, 25 mm. So this 35K is called as master apical file, isn't it? So from 35K, what you do is, with every 1 mm decrease in working length, you correspondingly increase the size of the file, isn't it? So this is how we proceed with step back technique, and I'm quite sure you're all familiar with this technique. So with every 1 mm decrease in the working length, we increase the size of the file correspondingly, right? So that's how we proceed with step back technique. But crown down technique is a concept where you try to follow the reverse manner, because the greatest disadvantage or drawback with this step back technique is, even though the advantage which we say with respect to step back technique is that you are able to clean the apical third first, so as a result you are achieving this apical stop, and then you are proceeding with middle third cleaning and kernel third cleaning. But in case of crown down technique, you are trying to remove the bulk of the debris or any remnants which are present over the kernel and middle third, and then you're proceeding with cleaning of apical third. As a result, so chances of apical extrusion are minimal, chances of transporting your canal are minimal, and chances of accessing your apical third in an efficient manner are even greater. So we have many advantages of crown down technique compared to step back technique. So crown down technique, we proceed from the kernel third, middle, and finally we go with apical third. So there is better access to the apical third and better penetrability of the ligands in this crown down technique. So that's the advantage we have with crown down over this step back technique. And if you look at the hybrid technique, so it basically optimizes or derives or uses the benefits of both step back and crown down. We'll go into details in our textbook discussion, right? And coming to various instruments which we use for these techniques. So usually all the hand instrumentation, stainless steel K files or even K reamers, we do follow step back technique. But all the rotary instruments which we are using nowadays, we do follow crown down or a hybrid technique. And as I mentioned previously, we have different functional motions, right? So we have filing motion, reaming motion, anti-curvature filing, which was given by Abu Ross and Jastrow, and then we have the circumferential filing and watch winding motion. So different kinds of filing techniques or reaming techniques are available. So when you are proceeding with step back, the kernel third and the middle third, they're cleaned using the reaming motion. This is very important. Whereas the apical third is cleaned using circumferential filing. The same is true in case of a hybrid technique also. So in step back technique and hybrid technique, the kernel third of a canal is cleaned using reaming motion, whereas the apical third is cleaned using your circumferential filing motion. Whereas in case of crown down, we usually use reaming motion, right? So that's how even your rotary instruments do work, right? So this is pertinent to various functional motions. And also, as I mentioned, this is very important. Step back technique, we are first starting with the apical third, right? So there is a greater chance for apical extrusion of debris, or there is a greater chance for over-instrumentation, and there can be post-operative symptoms as well. So, in order to overcome all this, we have this crown down technique where we're trying to remove the bulk of necrotic debris which is present over the kernel middle third of the canal, and then there is better access to your apical third, better irrigation penetration, and also the chances for a loss of working length or the chances for transportation of canal, all these negatives are overcome in this crown-down technique. So obviously crown-down technique is comparatively superior, right? But as I said, with step back, we can establish a positive apical stop. And these advantages of both step back and crown down are optimized and they're utilized in this hybrid technique, right? So this is an overview of the different techniques we have. Now let's look at various modifications of crown down technique. I'll just take 2 minute break, take some questions from you if at all, and then we'll proceed with the modifications of crown down technique. It's not audible, or maybe I'm talking at a low pitch. Okay, could you hear what I said so far? Could you at least hear, or is it difficult for you to catch the audio? Yeah, Prithvi, you can just watch our recorded video. We have done one video on various principal motions of instrumentation. You can refer our e-classes tomorrow morning, where we'll be posting you one video regarding the same. Okay, it's of low pitch. Okay. Yeah, the problem is maybe I was recording many videos today, various recorded videos. So I had this mic, so I got used to speaking at low pitch, maybe. Hi Komal, sure. Okay, anyways, don't worry, I'll just summarize at the end, right? So from now on, at least I'll try to raise my voice, right? And also let me know if it is clear or not, right? Okay, so I'll just summarize all that I've discussed so far at the end of the session. But before that, we'll just complete off different modifications we have in crown down technique. I'll just raise my voice and let me know if it is still not audible, right? So we have this conventional technique, which was given by Gorin. So as you can see, we start with, I mean, all these come under crown down, right? So we proceed from coronal to apical direction. So initially we use 15 to 25 H5 to the point where it binds in the canal, or 16 to 18 mm from the working length, or from the estimated working length on the coronal aspect. So after cleaning the coronal third with using 15 to 25 size H5, and then we use GG drills number 2 or 3, and in this process we try to complete off cleaning of coronal third of the canal, and middle and apical third they're cleaned using K5s of sequential sizes. We use a larger K5 initially at for example at 16 mm, we use 45 size K5. At 15 mm, you use 40 size K5. So the moment you go deeper into the canal, the size of the K file also has to be decreased correspondingly, and that's how you clean your middle third and apical third of a canal in case of a conventional crown down technique. So we start with 15 or 25 size H5, 15 to 25, it depends upon the size of the canal, and then you clean the coronal third using your GG drills number 2 and 3. And once you complete the coronal third cleaning, then you proceed to medial and apical third cleaning. That is possible by using these K5s of sequentially smaller sizes, right? So that's how we proceed with a conventional crown down technique. And if you observe this pressureless technique, which was given by Marshall and Papin, so here instead of H5, we use 35 size K5. 35 size K5 till it passively binds to the canal. And then we use GG drills either 2 or 3, and then we use K5s of sequential sizes till we reach the working length, right? So that's the summary of this pressureless technique. And balanced force technique is something where we use this concept of balancing of force. Like, we have this technique given by Rone and Sabala where we use a new file design that is Flexar file. And we have discussed about Flexar file previously, where we have this modified non-cutting tip so that there is the file remains centered inside the canal so that there won't be any transportation of canal or ledging of the canal. So in case of Flexar file also, we use GG drills, two or three sides to clean the kernel curve of the canal. And then within an apical curve, we use these Flexar files, right? So with Flexar files, as I mentioned, the transportation of canals or ledging of canals can be prevented and the file remains more centered. And this Flexar file is a K file with a modified non-cutting tip, right? And then we have this double flare technique where you use a combination of crown down and step back. So in double flare technique, we'll start from the kernel curve and proceed apically initially. And then we start from the apical third and then proceed kernel. So that's why it's called as double flare technique, right? So double flare technique is a concept which was given by Flower. So as I mentioned, we initially start using K files and then we proceed kernel to the apical third till the working length and then the reverse. Using the same K files with sequentially a progress to larger files, we proceed cleaning from the apical to kernel third. So this is double flare technique. And I'll just summarize all that I've discussed so far, but please let me know if I'm audible or if you still have issue with the audio. I'll try moving close to cam or I'll try to bring cam closer to the board. Okay, Komal, I'll definitely repeat the scientist's names also. Okay, right. So first we'll start with these techniques, right? As I mentioned, we have various principal techniques for root canal instrumentation. So we follow these techniques clinically. So we have this step back, crown down, or hybrid technique. So more or less, these techniques are used for shaping your canal in order to have a uniformly shaped canal so that there can be better penetrability of the root canal irrigants to the critical apical third of the canal. See, previously the objective was this we commonly say, like it's like we say cleaning and shaping. That was the previous concept. But now we are shaping for sake of cleaning. So we call it as shaping and cleaning. We're trying to shape the canal so that cleaning is possible, so that irrigants can penetrate to this critical apical third of the canal. We consider this apical third as critical because if you remember in one of the videos in E-classes, we have mentioned about the significance of apical third, where you have numerous ramifications, apical delta, and we have a lot of branches over there. So it's very much crucial for us to eliminate infection from that critical area, failing which there can be again reinfection, persistence of symptoms, or post-operative problems, right? So in order to access or in order to allow your irrigants to flow better into the apical third, we have this concept of shaping for sake of cleaning, right? So we have different shaping techniques. Like we have the step back, crown down, and hybrid technique. So as name itself indicates, step back, we start from the apical third and then proceed to middle and then kernel. And crown down technique is reverse of what we have discussed now. We'll start from the kernel third, proceed to the middle third, and then move towards the apical third. But hybrid technique is a combination of both, where we start with the kernel third and followed by apical third, followed by middle third. Now, most importantly, let me just give you the names of scientists and then we'll go into these details of, technique details. So as you can see, step back technique, the conventional step back technique was given by Wien, Clam and Wien. Clam, Wien and Schilder, three scientists. CLAM, Clam and Wien and also Schilder. Whereas step back passive technique, we have another technique called step back passive, which was given by Turabinejad. And then we have this crown down technique, the conventional crown down technique given by Goerig, G-O-E-R-I-G. Whereas the pressureless technique, crown down pressureless technique is given by Marshall and Patton. And you have this balanced force technique proposed by Rone and Sabala. And you have this double flare technique proposed by Flava. So these are some of the scientist names. And we also have this anti-curvature filing. It's a different filing technique, which was given by Abo, Ras, and Jastrap, right? We'll again discuss all this in our textbook discussion, right? Now, coming to step back technique. Step back technique, the concept here is, as I said, we start from the apical term. So we're trying to create an apical stalk first, and then we're proceeding with cleaning of middle and coronal third. But the problem here is, since you're dealing with apical third first, there can be a chance for apical extrusion. I mean, there can be difficulty for you to access that critical apical third, because since middle and coronal thirds are still unclean, there can be debris extrusion possible beyond that text. As a result, there can be post-op symptoms, post-op complaints, right? And moreover, there can be transportation of canal, because you have to place your file till your working length, and then you have something called as a recapitulation. So you have to place your file number of times till the working length. As a result, there can be transportation of canal, deviation of canal, ledge formation, or there can be various malformations happening inside your canal, iatrogenic induce damage happening to your canal, right? So these are some of the drawbacks we have with step back. So to overcome them, we have this crown down technique. So crown down technique is where we proceed from the coronal to the apical third. Since we are removing the coronal middle third of the canal first, since we are cleaning the coronal middle third first, so we have better access to the apical third, and we have this minimal chance of apical extrusion of debris, or minimal chance for canal transportation, because you are eliminating the barriers first, and then you're proceeding and cleaning the critical apical third. So these are some of the advantages we have with crown down technique, right? Over step back technique. But we have another concept of hybrid, which uses or optimizes the advantages of both crown down and step back. And most importantly, what are the different instruments we use for these techniques? So in case of step back technique, we usually use these stainless steel hand files. So these stainless steel hand files are used for cleaning your apical third, middle and coronal third using your step back technique. But all the rotary systems which we have nowadays, we more or less follow this reaming motion. We more or less follow this crown down technique or hybrid technique using these rotary instruments. So hand instruments, we use step back technique. Rotary instruments, we use this crown down or hybrid technique. Now, coming to various principal motions, as I mentioned, we have this filing, the reaming, anticurvature filing, circumferential filing, and watch winding motion. So these motions, where do you use them? In case of your step back and hybrid technique, we use reaming motion to clean the coronal third and circumferential filing motion to clean the apical third. But in case of crown down, we use reaming motion. So these are some of the differences we have with different techniques, right? And each one has its own purpose. And finally, we have various modifications given in crown down technique itself. So we have conventional crown down pressureless, balanced force, and double flip technique. They're very simple to understand. Just go through the names, you'll get the answer by itself. So since all are crown down techniques, we proceed from the coronal third towards the apical third. That's clear, right? So in conventional, we start using these H files. So 15 size file minimum or maximum up to 25 size H file can be used till it goes passively into the canal or to a length or to approximate working length of 16 to 18 mm. So from the cusp, for example, you proceed 16 to 18 mm. So till there, you clean the coronal third using your H files. And then we use Gates needle, either 2 size or 3 size, again to clean the coronal third. So using these two techniques, we're trying to clean the coronal third. And middle third to apical third, we use K files. Reverse to that, which we have seen in step back. So in step back, what do? We start from the apical third. For example, assume that the working length here is 25 mm. We're talking about step back. So 25 mm, your master apical file is 35. And 24 mm, your master apical file will be 40. And 22 mm, it will be 45. Something like that. So you're trying to sequentially increase the size of your K files as you're going short of the canal. So that's step back. And the reverse is followed in case of crown down, where you use a larger K file till it binds somewhere coronally here. So we, for example, assume that in crown down conventional, middle and apical third, you use a 60 size K file till here, and then you use a 55 size K file, 50 size K file, 40 size K file, 35 size K file, and 30 size K file, and ultimately 25 size K file till you reach working length. So that's how you sequentially decrease the size of the K files as you proceed from the middle third to the apical third till you reach working length. The same is a concept in all these techniques, right? However, the instruments, the sequence varies, that's it. So in case of conventional, we start with H5, JJ drills to complete off your kernel third cleaning, and then we proceed from the middle capacitor using these K files in a sequentially smaller diameter possible till you reach your working length, right? I hope it's clear. And then you have a specialist technique where apical pressure is not at all used, proposed by Marshall and Papin, where you use a 35 size K file to clean your kernel third, followed by using your JJ drills, and again the same K files in a sequentially decreasing size till you reach the working length. And balanced force technique proposed by Ronay and Sabana, where you use these flexar files which have modified cutting tip, so that there will be, I mean, the basic rationale behind reducing the cutting tip is so that the file remains centered inside the canal. Usually the cutting tip angle is 75 plus or minus 15, right? So this cutting tip is modified so that the file remains centered inside the canal without going and penetrating along the walls, so that there are less chances for ledging. And this balanced force technique, we have this technique mentioned where we place the file loaded in a clockwise direction to maximum of 90, and then we rotate it anti-clockwise to 180 to 270 degrees till a characteristic clicking sound is heard. So that's balanced force technique. So when you're trying to rotate the instrument clockwise, light pressure is applied, but when you're trying to rotate the instrument anti-clockwise, 180 to 270 degrees in a circle, you have to maintain the pressure so that the instrument doesn't pop out. So all this we'll discuss again in detail, right? So balanced force technique is something where we use JJ drills initially, and then middle capacitor cleaning is done using these modified K files, that is flexar files, as we have discussed previously. And then you have this double flare technique, which was proposed by Flower. It's very simple. You use K files larger to smaller to proceed from kernel to apical third, and then we use again these K files from the apical third to kernel third. So it's basically again a combination of crown down technique and step back technique, right? So this is about different modifications we have in crown down technique and hybrid technique, as we discussed in brief. That's how we proceed. We start with kernel, and then with apical, and then with middle third. And we'll go into the details of all these techniques further in our textbook discussion, right? So this is in brief about various principal instrumentation techniques of your root canal instrumentation, right? So you have any questions, you can drop them. I'll wait for a few more minutes, and then we'll proceed to textbook discussion. It's been streaming fine for me. So I assume there is no issue from my side, at least. Yeah, I'm sorry, it's not FLAVA, it's FAVA, F-A-V-A. Yeah, thank you. Thanks, Gina. Yeah, it's FAVA, F-A-V-A. So I'm really sorry for that. See, as I said, the whole day I've been recording some videos. So we usually use this mic, right? So I got used to talking at low pitch. So forgetting that I don't have a mic here, I continue speaking in the same pitch. Yes, S. Komal, hope you have gone through the scientist names again. Yes, for here, clockwise 90 degrees followed by counterclockwise 180 to 270 degrees, maintaining apical pressure. That's your balanced force technique. Master apical file is nothing but the largest file you place till your working length. So that's your master apical file. Yes, crown down is also called as step down saiga. So both are the same. Crown down technique. Conventional crown down is also called as step down technique. Hi, Manasa. Thank you for your compliment. Yes, sir, except Tugback effect, we get what is other way to determine master Tugback phi. I didn't get your question, Prithvi. Can you just reframe it? Hi, Mini, good evening. Yes, for him, control fails. Give me the context, right? When do you get that point? What is the context? Yeah, I've been using a laptop here. I think it is streaming fine. Anyways, I'm not sure what's wrong today. You say it's breaking. How is it streaming now? Yes, we do have some echo in this room. Hi, Pooja. Okay, fine. Step down technique is something which is different than hybrid technique. Hybrid technique is a combination of step back and step down techniques. Yes, hi Akshay. I hope it's clear. I mean, is it audible or do you want me to raise my voice still? Yes, Akshay, you're welcome. Okay, right. Okay, Komal, right. So I hope you guys could follow what we have summarized so far. So we'll just break in that case and we'll restart with our textbook discussion. Okay, is it fine then? So it's 9:35. Shall we start again by 9:45 then? 10 minutes. Yeah, hi, Bernice. It's mentioned as 35K file, Prithvi. Pressureless technique, it's mentioned as 35K file, initially. Okay then, right. In that case, I'll break and we'll start again by 9:45. Okay, it's already 9:37 now. We'll start in another 5-10 minutes. Diti, we'll just discuss that. We'll go into the details in our textbook discussion, right? Yeah. It was not actually, Diti, it's not mentioned in Grossman in new edition. But as far as my knowledge is concerned, we'll start with larger file possible and then we'll just try to follow the anatomy. Like for example, I said we start with from the kernel third and proceed with the apical third initially, right? So you take a largest instrument possible, 60 size or 75, depends upon the canal or depends upon the tube. And then you progressively decrease the size and then you'll decrease it to an extent till you reach the apical third or till you reach your working length. And then once you're done, we'll again restart with K files using 15 or 10 size at established patency and then sequentially increase the size of the file with every 1 mm decrease in working length. So that's how we proceed with kernel third, apical third cleaning and vice versa in case of a double flare technique. It's not specific, it's not mentioned in Grossman as well, but I suppose that's how we follow. Yeah, it's been standardized, but however, with experience, you can customize and you can practice your own way. But these have been standardized so that these will be the best starting point for any novel person or any new person to start with, right? Yeah, Prithvi, there are lot many indications. As I said, we'll have a group discussion. We'll get all the information over there, right?
Yeah.
So we'll just break and we'll see you again in 5 to 10 minutes time, right? 9:40, 9:45 or 9:50, we'll start again, right? Bye.